Dear students, today we will discuss Bose Einstein statistics. We have already discussed Bose Einstein statistics in the introduction part, where we said that Bose-Einstein statistics basically involves particles which are indistinguishable, and also any number of particles can occupy a given energy level. Next point that we discussed in the introduction part of Bose-Einstein was, this statistics is basically obeyed by particles having integral spin. For example, hydrogen, deuterium molecule, nitrogen molecule, helium 4, and photons. And one more point regarding this statistics was that the particles which obey the Bose-Einstein statistics were called as bosons. Now, today we will go through its derivation and to find it the most probable distribution of this Bose-Einstein statistics. Okay. So, for example, first we will consider a system made up of n, capital N, indistinguishable particles. Very important, indistinguishable particles. And this N, capital N, it is basically made up of N1 plus N2 plus N3 plus dash dash up to total N number of particles, or we can say bosons. So, such that this Ni particles are supposed in the ith energy level, and their degeneracy is simply represented by Gi. Now, the Ni particles have to be distributed among Gi states. We have these number of states and we have to distribute Ni number of bosons. One more point, first you have to remember is this: suppose if we have a simple pair, suppose, and we have to make 5 parts of this pair. So what we do, we'll cut it 1 time, 2 times, 3 times, and 4 times. That means in 4 partitions, we get actually how many? We get basically 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 parts. That means this is basically, you can imagine this, that these lines or these cuts are basically partitions. And by using only 4 partitions, you can make 5 compartments. So you have to remember this example. Very simple, you can take any other example. Suppose you have an apple or something like that, and you have to make, suppose, 6 compartments. How many cuts you need? Simply 6 minus 1, that is 5. So similarly, what we do here, imagine that the ith energy level has Gi minus 1 partitions. You have to remember these partitions will be Gi minus 1. These will be the partitions which are sufficient to separate the energy level into Gi intervals. but I have shown you the simple example. Suppose you have a circular something like that, and you have to make suppose three parts or four parts. Suppose four parts. How many cutters you need? You need only 1, 2, and 3. You will get how many parts? 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. It is the same situation like here, that for the ith energy level has how many GI minus 1 partitions, which basically separate this into energy level GI intervals. Now the possible number of distributions Ni particles among GI states may be determined by permuting the array of partitions and particles, that means interchanging. Okay, so the total number of permutations of Ni particles and GI minus 1 partitions, these will be the Ni will be the particles and partitions will be GI minus 1. That will be simply equal to how many total permutations? Ni plus GI minus 1 factorial. So this is very simple. This will be the number of particles, Ni. GI minus will be the number of partitions. And if we take their sum and their factorial, that will be simply equal to the total number of permutations. Okay, for this system. So, however, the partitions and particles are indistinguishable. That means you cannot distinguish. Suppose in energy level there are 3 particles, in energy level there are 2, in energy level 3 there are suppose 6 particles. If we interchange one of the particles, suppose this is 1, 2 and 3, there are 1, 2 and 3, we can interchange this particle with this, and it always remains 3 here. They will remain as 3 also. So this is basically indistinguishable. This implies that interchanging two partitions does not alter an arrangement. You will see here, we interchanged one of the particles with each other and it does not have any effect on their arrangement. So also interchanging two particles does not alter an arrangement. First partition and then arrangement. Here it is basically partition. Partitions. It does not change that and does not change arrangement. This is okay. So right. Now, what we do, we have to find out now the number of arrangements. So for that case, we will actually divide these Ni plus GI minus 1 factorial by number of permutations, GI minus 1 partitions, that means GI minus 1 factorial, and the Ni particles, that means the Ni factorial. So simply we will write here the number of arrangements for ith state, that means the Ni particles will be in the suppose energy level Ei. We will write it as Ni plus GI minus 1 factorial upon n factorial GI minus 1 factorial. Very, very important relation in case of this Bose-Einstein statistics. Okay. What we have already done in case of Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, that we assume that the total number of particles is constant, that means the summation of Ni is basically equal to n and it is equal to constant when we considered a closed system. So, and also their energy also remains a constant. These were the 2 points which we took into consideration while deriving the maximum probability for Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics. Similarly, we will take these 2 points also into consideration here in the Bose-Einstein stochasticus as well. Okay. First, we know the total number of particles will be constant for a closed system, and total energy of the system will also be constant. So it is here written U is equal to summation Ni Ei, which is also equal to constant. Now, the thermodynamic probability, which is represented by W for the system of n particles, that means the total number of particles, number of ways of distributing n particles among various energy levels, is given by this simple formula. W is equal to pi I, this is just the product, Ni plus Gi minus 1 factorial upon Ni factorial Gi minus 1 factorial into constant. This is like, suppose if we have the first N1 particles in the energy level 1, we can write it as N1 plus G1 minus 1, similarly N1 G1 minus 1, and for second we will multiply with N2 plus G2 minus 1. N2 factorial G1 minus that means G minus 1 factorial, and similarly, that means this is just in the product formation, what we have already done in the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. We will here similarly take logarithm on both sides, and also what you have to consider, you have to consider that this Gi is also a constant, and the total number of these particles is also a constant. Okay, so while transforming this into this log form, you will see that this becomes basically log m plus log n, and this becomes log m by n, and log m by n will be equal to log of m minus log of n, and you can make this product into summation then, because that will change into plus minus and so on. What we write it here, summation I ln of ni gi minus 1 factorial, so it will be same here, then negative, it will be when we apply log to both sides, this will change to summation, and this will be log m by log m, log m by log n, that will be log m minus log n, so we will write it here. This is minus, we will also make this log m into n into log m plus n, minus is outside, so it will be plus minus minus again, so you will get this relation here, this expression. So it is very simple, do it yourselves or follow the first video lecture of this, I have shown you what to do there. So what we have considered here too, that Ni and Gi are very large numbers, and we can use simply the Stirling's approximation, that means ln of x factorial will be equal to x ln of x minus x, to obtain this relation. We will apply here Stirling approximation to this and also to this, and you have to remember Gi and Ni, they will be constant here, and simply you will get this relation. Also, one more point you have to take into consideration, that while transforming this into Stirling approximation, we simply take that this is very very large as compared to 1 and neglect this one here as well as here. So we have actually set Ni plus Gi minus 1 is equal to Ni plus Gi. Why? Because this number is very very huge as compared to 1. Similarly, this number is very large as compared to 1. So we write it here. As Ni is very large, it can also be treated as a continuous variable. Okay. So if we differentiate this equation now, so and setting that differential equal to 0, why? Because we have to maximize that quantity. If any student does not follow this setup, please go to my previous lecture and I have explained there what to do. So we are following the same condition here also. So I am not repeating those steps here. So it will be simply differential of ln of w, partial differential I am taking, it will be summation ln of ni minus ln of ni gi, and delta ni will be equal to zero, or you can write it as log m minus log n form. So it will be log of m by n, delta ni will be also equal to zero. So we actually came across to this relation here. So from the equation 6 and 7, we know delta n will be equal to summation of delta small ni, which will basically equal to zero, because differential of a constant is equal to zero, and similarly differential of this total energy will also be equal to zero. Now we will apply the Lagrange's undetermined multipliers to equation 7, 8, and 9. Basically what we do, we actually multiply equations 7 and 8 with these variables, undetermined multipliers. We will see in the future classes how this is done. So here you have to simply remember that we are actually using the Lagrange undetermined multipliers to this equation 7 and 8, 9. We will get this equation there. That means summation I ln ni upon ni gi plus alpha plus beta ei delta ni is equal to zero. And we know this differential of ni, it is basically independent of one another. So what we write here, we will write here this, the coefficient, that means the coefficient of delta ni will be equal to then zero. Okay, so we will write only the coefficient, that means ln ni upon ni plus gi plus alpha plus beta ei will be equal to zero. So this is the term here. So also we can simply transform this relation into this one. What we have to do, we have to simply take this part to this side, it will be minus alpha minus beta ei, then do the inverse of that, that mean will be, it will be minus, and it will be then, or take the inverse of this, we will get this one, and it will be negative, and negative negative will cancel out, and it becomes positive alpha plus beta ei. So it is ni divided to both terms. When you take the inverse of this, it will be ni plus gi upon ni. So it will be ni plus ni upon ni will be equal to one. So what I am talking about, you can write this in this form, minus ln of ni plus gi upon ni. Now give this ni to both terms and you will see it will turn out to be this, because minus is there, minus and minus will be cancelled, so it will be alpha plus beta yeah. So we will get this equation, very simple. Now you have to multiply by both sides with the exponential, you know exponential and logarithm will go here, it will be e raised power alpha plus beta ei. We will see in the future classes that this beta, this comes out to be 1/kT. K is Boltzmann's constant, T is absolute temperature. So first, for sake of simplicity, first remember this is alpha plus beta ei, or this beta value comes out to be 1/kT. We will see that, we will also derive that, but in the future class. So from this relation, what we get here, so what we are doing, we will write it as gi upon ni, take this plus 1 to here, it will be minus 1. So and take the inverse, and you will write, or simply take ni here and take this to this, it will be ni is equal to gi upon e raised power alpha plus beta I minus 1. So you actually got a very, very important relation. This x is the expression basically for the most probable distribution of n particles among the various energy levels according to Bose-Einstein statistics. So this was basically a little bit about this Bose-Einstein statisticus. Please also follow my the previous lecture, Maxwell-Boltzmann statisticus, that will clear a few of this, some of the relations, how they are derived. Now we will actually go towards the application part of this, and first we will see can we derive some of the relations or some of the factors, how thermodynamic probability is basically derived for the case. Suppose we are taking a simple example. Please follow it very carefully. Here, what we have actually taken five identical indistinguishable particles, and those are basically distributed over five energy levels with energy suppose 0, E, 2IC, 3IC, and 4E. That means total five energy levels 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and each one is basically five-fold degenerate. That means GI is basically equal to 5. Here you have to remember GI will also be always be equal to 5. Let the total energy of the system be 4E. You know it will be 0 plus this much. Total energy, upper energy will be equal to 4E. It is given. So what we do here, we are actually building a simple table here. Suppose these are five energy levels, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And this is also 0E with a particular energy. So suppose in the first case, four indistinguishable particles are in the ground state and one is in the 4E state. And how to calculate thermodynamic probability for that? We will use the simple this relation. Thermodynamic probability will be equal to product of Ni plus Gi minus 1 factorial upon Gi minus 1 factorial n factorial. How to solve it? Here you have to take basically the product of all the energy levels. How? First one, in the first time we will take first for the first case, first energy level. Here for the first zero energy level here, zero for ground state, what we will write here, here n is equal to, n will be equal to 4. We will write first 4, okay. Then it is plus, okay, we will write plus. Then the degeneracy, it is five-fold degenerate, we will write it as 5. Then from this relation it is minus 1, okay, we will write that, and it is whole factorial upon GI will be equal to 5, so we will write it as 5, and it will be minus 1, we will write it same, and it is factorial, and n is how many in the this state, first state, ground state, that is 4. 4 factorial. So this comes out to be 5 minus 1 will be 4. 4 plus 4 will be 8. So it comes out to be first the 8 factorial upon 5 minus 1 will be 4 factorial. So it is 4 factorial and it is also 4 factorial. So this is only for the ground state now. Now we will calculate for the second state. This is the first excited state, you can say. For this case, number of particles is, we will again calculate it here so that all the students get it, how to solve it. So for the second state, basically they are all in the product. That is why we write it as 5. Okay, they are all in the product form. So the number of particles in the first excited state is equal to 0. We will use the same equation plus the degeneracy is equal to 5. Okay, minus 1, and it is factorial from the equation, and then 5 minus 1 factorial, and here number of particle is equal to 0, so it will be 0 factorial. 0 factorial. You will see 5 minus 1 will be, well, that means simply 4 factorial. So you will write it as 4 factorial here. 5 minus 1 will be 4 factorial, so it is 4 factorial, and 0 factorial, it is 0 factorial. Similarly, for this state, same can be followed, because number of particles will be 0. Degeneracy is equal to 5 minus 1 factorial. Again, 5 minus 1, 0 factorial, that comes out to be same, 4 factorial upon 4 factorial, 0 factorial. Similarly, for the third case, here number of particles is equal to 0, so it will be the same. Thermodynamic probability for this case, 4 factorial upon 4 factorial upon 0 factorial. Now, you can see for this case, number of particles is equal to 1. Simply, what you have to replace? You have to replace here, n is equal to 1, here n is equal to 1. And what you get here, plus and minus will go, it will be 5 factorial. And it will be 5 minus 1, it will be 4 factorial, and it will be 1 factorial. So this is basically the thermodynamic probability for this case, where this distribution is given. Similarly, you can use this equation, where n, what this is always in multiplication, so you have to take all energy levels into consideration and do the multiplication by using the same equation for every case. Okay, here what we use for this case, here it will be, I will show it here again. Here n will be equal to 3, g will be 5 minus 1, so it comes out to be 7 factorial. Okay, again, 5 minus 1, 4 factorial, and number of particles will be 3 factorial. So you will get this. Similarly, you have to follow for the other cases as well. And please do this example and also upload in your respective these WhatsApp groups so that I can check whether you have done rightly or not. Okay, thank you for your patience.